in the Gulf. I'm sure many of you know these people, and we can connect with each other. And our idea is to take all the initiatives of this hard work of Matthew Sir for quite a number of years now. And I'm pleased to be a member of this elite gathering. Thank you so much. And you can count on me, and I'll be there always at your call. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. I know that you have been a great supporter of this, right from our Delhi Teachers Forum and then all the other initiatives that you have taken. Thank you so much. So may I request anybody else that, you know, since many of you have been associated with quite a number of, I think, months or even years probably with us, you know how we function and the authenticity of our programs and what we do exactly. Now, how do we reach out to a global audience is a different ballgame altogether, right? It requires a lot more, you know, commitment from everyone. It requires a lot more resources. So I just want, since we have a good resource pool, I said, why don't we make use of it, of this platform in reaching out? So if anybody wants to share any idea, let it be any brain, you can just go ahead and speak. There is nothing right or wrong here, just opinions matter. Please, somebody can unmute themselves and start. Thank you.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Please.
Okay.
Sunila, ma'am is speaking?
Yeah.
Please, ma'am.
Whosoever. Yeah. So, good evening, everyone. Myself, Sunila Kalra. I have been working as PGT Economics in Modern School, Barakamba Road for 22 years, and overall, I have experience of almost 27 years now. I think it's a wonderful opportunity. I feel that this pandemic rather has thrown us an opportunity amidst crisis that now we can reach everyone virtually. The idea of the global meet now seems to be easier than before, that now we can connect to everyone sitting from our homes, and there's no need to travel, and we don't have to worry about seeking permissions and other expenses. So now we can exchange a lot of ideas. I think it would be wonderful if we can connect to teachers from all over the world, whether it is African or Gulf countries or Europe or US, and we can exchange ideas with them first and resources with them. And then we can move on to see that how we can have exchange programs virtually first, so that we can have exchange of ideas with the students and with the teachers as well, whichever are the best practices which are followed in any part of the world. And now is the time to overhaul the education system, now that we have realized that we can do away with either one third of the syllabus or 50% of the syllabus as the government in Delhi is proposing. So how better we can use the resources and how better the teaching community can come into force. This is the time to do so, and we are at the right time and with the right opportunity. Thank you, all of you.
I think very valid points. This is the best time to reach out. That I totally agree. I mean, so we were not equipped for this, and suddenly we are all into this. And I couldn't agree more with Sunila, ma'am, that this is the best time to launch all this. So thank you, ma'am. And we are definitely looking forward to such initiatives. Anybody else would like to speak something?
Sir, good evening. Sir, may I?
Yes, ma'am, please.
May I, please? Myself, Dr. Narchi, and I am working as Vice Principal at GHPS, Kalkaji. So, sir, my main thing is that there are very variety of different delivery models that are available these days that work best for learning. You know, a variety of varied form of delivery models that are necessary to meet the variability of our learners. If we can do something about how different schools across the continent, across the countries, across the nations are, which all delivery models are they using which work best for our children? We can apply those in our own respective schools and in our own respective zones. I think that is something that we should always, you know, we can work forward.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Anybody else?
Matthew, sir, can I make a point?
Yes, Jamila, ma'am. We can't hear you.
Jamila, ma'am, please go ahead.
Just a minute. Yeah, thank you, sir. I'm a teacher of English, and literature is very close to my heart. So my little is that, you know, I'd like to initiate a book discussion across countries. So we could call teachers, you know, maybe, you know, a nice book that they have read. So it can be discussed with, I don't know, I mean, this is just one idea. I mean, you know, we can have a series of book discussions.
Yeah.
Maybe once a month or something. We
can
connect over books.
Thank you, ma'am.
So I would like to add on to this.
Yes,
if it's a book club kind of a thing, sir.
Yes.
I'm Ritu Bhandari.
Yes,
and
yes, ma'am. Please.
Like a book club kind of a thing. Maybe we can have a chart out a kind a plan for a month, say, and then one book in 15 days, maybe. And have a discussion amongst ourselves only.
And
Mr.
When we talk about book discussion, we don't mean fiction only, you know. It could be non-fiction in case other people are feeling left out. You know, like, you know, that it's not eco, that it's not, you know, when we talk about books, discussing books, we're not talking about only...
It could be on any discipline.
Yes.
Right.
It could be on any discipline. And in addition to what you're saying, Ma'am Jameela, we could also have film reviews. Like, you know, movies that are globally appreciated all over the world. So, you know, we can just... just for, you know, the sake of taking their viewpoints, understanding their culture, understanding their mindset. So it becomes a nice global platform. And since now we have performing arts, theater, music, dance, maybe we could do something. Since I am, you know, a person who's very culturally inclined, as well as an English person, I think it is a good idea to combine the two and, you know, reach out. And I mean, not that we cannot reach out in other subjects, but... through this, maybe we can just take it further. So, if we have...
Can I please add on to this?
Yes, Sarika ma'am.
Good evening, everyone. And I'm Mrs. Sarika from Delhi Public School, Arkipuram. And I've been teaching. I'm senior computer science faculty over there. And I've been teaching in the school for almost 22 plus years. I just have two, three points that I wanted to make with this respect. The first thing is, because it's absolutely a new platform for all of us. For students, I won't say, because they are quite computer savvy, but yes, for the teachers. So being into the computer field, I just thought that if we can just talk to the teachers and discuss about the kind of difficulties that some of them are facing while they are conducting the online classes, number one. Number two, the different modes that we can provide them, because I belong to the field, so we can have a workshop. Number three, a lot of difficulties at this point of time, a lot of teachers are facing regarding are they are attending, are they listening to the class, they are not listening to the class and all that. So how to cope up with that kind of problem and stress what teachers are facing. That's another thing. Now, apart from that, when some of the teachers were talking about the book discussions and all that, that's a very, very good idea. Like, we can always have small session on alternate days of yoga. If we have a yoga faculty in one of the schools, can just help us out, where we can have yoga faculty coming like on alternate days, or we can have for 10 minutes providing 10 minute session or 15 minute session. And apart from that, as the book reading is concerned, rather there are people who do story interpretation. So they take you know, they interpret the stories, they call the students of a particular category. It could be a wide range of category, it could be a smaller category maybe. I mean, I'm talking about with respect to the age. So inviting those students and involving them through the actions and through the... Because a simple book reading will not going to probably help.
Thank you, ma'am. I would request all those who are speaking to keep it short. I would request everyone to keep it short, because, you know, otherwise everyone will not get a chance to speak. So let's keep it to about 1 minute or 2 minutes, so that, you know, all, because we are just meeting for 30 minutes. I think because, see, the sharing can be done in the group. So what today we are just initiating, we thought that we'll meet up and at least we'll start off with this. So all those who are speaking, request to just keep it short and sweet. Thank you.
Good evening, sir.
One more thing.
Yes. Dimple, ma'am, you go ahead. After that, Rohini, ma'am, you can speak. Yes.
I'll try to keep it very short and crisp right now. Definitely, sir, it's a very great platform that is being initiated now. And congratulations to the entire team. But besides academics, I'm just going to try to highlight on the mental health issues too, because that is on the rise. Because we're talking about the preparation of the teachers, the students and the parents for this kind of situation right now. But we are forgetting that first of all, they need to get into that frame of mind and accepting the reality. So for that, the mental health issues also need to be addressed and taken up with the students, with the teachers, with the management, or even in fact with the parents. Something can be planned at that level too, including the children with special needs too.
Yes, that can be
also focused area, because that is another one challenge that we are facing right now as mental health.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. That's a very good point.
Yes, sir. I just want to add to this. Yes, ma'am. I'm Himlata Suri this side.
Ma'am, just once again, just let Rohini ma'am speak, then I'll give you the...
Okay, it was just continuation to what she said.
Yes, ma'am,
okay.
Just because she's been waiting for a long time, I'm sorry.
All right.
It's okay. Let her continue.
No, ma'am, please. Rohini ma'am, please.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Rohini from Faith Academy, and I've been teaching history for around 20 years or so. And what I feel, since we are going global now, we all have friends, we all have relatives who are actually settled abroad, or maybe they are into teaching abroad. So why don't we invite them, and you know, they can join along with us, so that if we understand our Indian or our CBSE system of education has been very different from what education is abroad. And today when we look back, you know, when we talk about education, we know our education has undergone a total complete change. We are taking Zoom classes. Half the time, we don't even know whether it's the parent who's sitting over there and attending the class, or it is actually the child, because the videos are switched off.
Thank you.
Right?
Yes, ma'am. That's
so, we need to actually encourage, and we need to understand, because they have been doing it for much, much more, much larger time. You know, they have been using Google Classrooms for a longer period of time. Zoom, if we know, Zoom is a pretty old app. Nobody ever used to use Zoom earlier, but now suddenly everybody is dependent on Zoom, because now the times need it so, right? So we can always inculcate different style of teaching rather than the lecture and the way we
generally. What we are going to do actually after the meeting is that whatever program you wish to initiate, you will post in the group, and then we'll work accordingly. Because see, somebody has to take ownership of these. If you are suggesting book reading or film review or something, you need to take ownership of that and start the program. We are there to support you in whatever programs we initiate. We'll give you the platform. We'll get you connected. But the initiative has to be from your side.
One more thing. Like, we need to have a common platform where we can pool our lessons. For example, somebody has conducted a flipped class, a beautiful flipped lesson, which can help many others also. So we need a common platform where we can upload our lessons, so that if somebody else who needs a lesson on that particular topic does not go on preparing, you know, spending hours preparing the same.
We are soon creating our own website. We are working on our website.
That's what I mean.
Yeah. So
maybe a YouTube channel or a website. Even I am.
Or a Google Drive.
Just give us some time. We'll do it. Ma'am, Himlata Suri, ma'am, please.
Yes. Yes, I am Himlata Suri. Good evening, all. I work with the Carmel Convent School, Chanakyapuri, as special educator and counselor, and work with the CBSE too. And I just wanted to add to what Dimple ma'am said. Because of this pandemic, we expect another epidemic on mental health and drug abuse issues, and especially the children with special needs. We need to, sir, really create awareness about these children. Most of the people working in school are unaware of, all these children. And so we need to work on diversity and inclusion issues very closely, I feel. So we can create maybe a month, maybe once a month, or maybe twice, once in 2 months, such kind of awareness drives, and we can have a presentation or something like this. We can have simple discussions.
Sure. So what we are going to do is that divide ourselves into different groups depending on our expertise.
Sir.
You know, because everyone cannot work on everything. Everyone is not an expert.
Yes, sir.
So we'll do that as soon as. Yes, ma'am. Jameela, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
30 seconds.
Sir, I think it's also the right time. I'm just trying to weave this in with what Matt said about mental health issues. You know, this is a quote popularly attributed to Einstein. I don't know how far it is, but anyway, the line is relevant. It says that you cannot solve an issue at the same level which created that issue in the first place. So I feel that we are trying to deal with issues with the same level of consciousness. So I think it's going to be important and relevant if we revisit important terms that we use all the time. For example, education. What exactly is education? Have we somewhere forgotten? Have we mistaken the woods for, you know, the trees for the woods? Okay, are we doing something wrong fundamentally? Do we need to do some kind of a soul searching? What actually education is? What actually learning is? How does the UNESCO define the four pillars of learning? Do we even know about it? You know, do the things that we do for classroom sake, is it in keeping with what is supposed to be done?
Yes, ma'am.
So these kind of revisiting our roots. I mean, I can call it that, you know, I mean,
you,
for
ma'am.
Right now.
Annie, ma'am.
Sir, can I speak?
Annie, ma'am.
Can I speak?
Annie, ma'am, yes.
Good evening, Matthew, sir, and everybody on this esteemed panel. First of all, I'd just like to say a big thank you to Matthew, sir, for having organized this. I'm Annie. I teach in Mater Dei School, Delhi. I'm school coordinator, and I'm also head department of English. So, what I was thinking was,
ma'am, your voice is going.
Ma'am, just check your... can everyone hear that?
No.
Annie, ma'am, just check your volume or the speaker. Yeah, we cannot hear
you. Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, somewhat okay. Better, yes.
Better now?
Yes. Go ahead,
better,
please.
Better. Okay, good. So good evening, everyone. Thanks, Matthew, sir, for organizing this. And everybody, good evening on the panel. It's just, I'm Annie. I'm from Mater Dei School, Delhi. And I'm school coordinator. And I'm also head department of English. I was just... wondering that, we need to do a lot keeping the children in mind, because the pandemic now, the kids are really stressed out. Like, for instance, we took some trial classes yesterday because we just recently shifted from Zoom to Microsoft Teams. Kids are at home for maybe 3 to 4 months, and we need something for them as a stress buster. And also, I think we need to keep 21st century skills in mind, because now with the CBSE trying to cut down on syllabus, bringing in art integrated learning, etc. So we, all of us together need to do a lot of thinking on these lines. And, we need to think what we can do for the children. Of course, all of us collaborating and coming together and doing something for them.
Yes, ma'am. Very valid point. Not only for the teachers, but reaching out to the kids as well. Very, very valid point. Yes. Thank you. Ruchi, ma'am, you're very silent today. Ruchi Sangar, ma'am, please switch on your mic and say something.
I'm just overwhelmed. I mean, I feel that way whenever I come to this platform. My credentials, I'm still blossoming. And I don't mean that in the literal sense, in a very academic sense. Okay. So based on what I've heard all the distinguished speakers talk about, the takeaway for me is, A, we need to have different kind of platforms. And then once we establish those, we need to sort of get going with our topics. So topics galore, as many subjects, general topics, teachers, they can be. So the platforms, I think, could be, because not everybody may be comfortable with face-to-face. So it could be a discussion forum kind of a thing where we could have people here as moderators taking in and, people just expressing themselves. We could have a moderator conducting a kind of a discussion like Jamila mentioned. We could definitely have workshops. We could definitely have talks. So it's a whole lot out there. Once we establish our platforms, I'm sure the topics will flow.
And we are counting on your expertise for all this. We had a lovely session the other week.
Yes, Matthew sir, may I speak something?
Yes, ma'am. I was just about to call your name. Even if you wouldn't have spoken, I would have taken your name. Yes, ma'am. Suchi, ma'am.
Good evening, sir. And a very warm good evening to everybody. Now, I'm a very practical person. And of course, with due respect to everybody, I want to make a point that since there are many principals in this group, so what we can do is, principal knows their teachers in the best way. They know their caliber, they know their capabilities. For example, I'm saying with due respect to everybody, suppose in my school, one of a maths teacher teaching class 11th or so, it's not good. I mean, she is not capable enough or she's not good enough to deliver. Maybe she must be comfortable with her concepts, but somehow he or she is not able to deliver her concepts to the students. So can we, through this platform, can we just request the principal of the other schools to arrange some classes for our students? For example, during this pandemic, suppose some teachers are getting retired. So it is not possible to have the, call anybody, we cannot have teachers. So can we, through those principles, can we have, suppose chemistry teachers or whosoever is retiring from our school, can we have teachers from that school to help our students during this time, especially during this time?
Yes. Sort of workshops for the children, you mean?
No, ma'am. No, I'm asking.
Regular classes.
Regular classes. Yeah. So
she means keeping classes. Even if not regular, maybe a guest twice faculty. A week or so.
Like a guest faculty.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, I'll come up. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. We can definitely. It's a good point. And since there will be many volunteers, we are not going to allot anything here. What we'll do is we'll identify the areas which we'll post, and probably people can just pick up that and work on it for the next 1 month. Probably we can meet once in a month to see what is the progress that we are making on different areas, and then we'll work on that. So right now we are just going into the regular stage.
And the cultural programs also. Which are different in a way, because as Prem sir is very much there, I think he's the best person to help me out in this. Even the cultural program, even the best cultural activities which are carried out there, and we can get some inspiration from ideas from those cultural activities.
Yes, of course.
Now we can have virtual activities also, and we've been having them to a great extent and very successfully, not only in our school, but in different societies and organizations. We have been doing it, and it's working brilliantly.
Okay. Even ma'am, we are also doing it in our school, even subject-wise.
Matthew sir, may I?
Yes, ma'am. Matthew, Archana. Yes, Archana, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah, hello, everyone. Hello. This is Archana Rodrick. I'm from Mumbai. And actually, I've been listening to a lot of this. In fact, I was there for the earlier meeting, but I lost connectivity. I agree with what Suchi ma'am was saying here about being practical over here, and also what I think Ruchi ma'am you are saying here, that there's lots to do. What I feel is that we need to ourselves chalk down what are the areas in which we can contribute in what way, and maybe somebody was a special educator, Himlata over here. Nice to meet you. I'm also a special educator from Mumbai. So we have many areas that we take trainings for. So what is your forte as a counselor, as a psychologist, as a special educator, as a teacher, mentor? We all have certain skills. We have many feathers on our cap. So I would say we chalk down all that and then put it in the group. And then, once we decide the stakeholders, like we have so many stakeholders to work with. One is most importantly for us are the teachers, because we are all leaders here. So, to some extent, training the teachers and empowering them. So I think Sarika ma'am spoke here about, she's the IT teacher. So I was totally thrilled, because I know the kind of struggle we have had with teachers who have been teaching in a particular way for the last 30 years. And all of a sudden they're asked to go online and they are just not able to do that. So it becomes difficult. So we have so many skills in this group itself, in this room of 30 people. So let's chalk down what are the things in which we can contribute, and also very practically speaking, how are we able to give that kind of time currently, and what is the amount of time that we can give, maybe on the weekends, maybe in the evening. So based on that, I think Matthew sir is the right, a brilliant person over here who will be able to work on creating certain modules, looking at the various stakeholders, whether it is teachers, whether it is parents, whether it is students, and more importantly, since I am from management part also, we have an organization of private unaided schools here, CBSE, State Board, ICSE schools. So a lot of issues the management is also facing now because of unlimited government interference, lack of clarity. At least the CBSE, sir from Kuwait, I would like to say CBSE, you are saying, is not clear. But let me tell you, the state governments are even in a bad, worse state. There is no clue what is going on. There are no circulars being sent on time. Everything is just trial and error kind of with schools.
Yes,
So at the moment, there's a lot of unrest among the management, among the teachers. So I think the first stakeholder we need to figure out are the teachers, because they are being affected in a big way during this pandemic. So if at all we are able to chalk out, what are the things that we can contribute for teacher development, whether mental health, emotional development?
So I'd like to add on to this.
Just 1 second. She said that she is a special educator and counselor. Also, just want to tell you that she is the principal of St. Joseph's, Mumbai. She didn't add that part, so I just wanted to introduce her. So
okay, yeah. Thank you. But then we are all teachers. Thank you, Matthew, sir, for that. Thank you. So I felt that after this meeting, there should be a follow-up action of putting what we, if we are putting that we can take this session, then it's a commitment that, yes, we need to find time. So I think we all need to practically think, are we able to give that time and what is the amount of time that we can give?
Yes, ma'am.
Then we'll move ahead.
We have just now 5 minutes. We'll just wind up on time. 5 minutes. Yes. So anybody else wants
to? I'd like to just say something.
I'm here for the first time today. Can I say something?
Who's that, ma'am?
Yes.
Your name?
Harmita Kaid Mathis, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Please. Yes, ma'am.
Hi. It's really great to connect with a very nice and well-equipped, talented team over here. I just wanted to share my thoughts on the conversation that I was just hearing. And this is my first time attending the meeting. Thanks for that, obviously. Hi, Alka. Hi, Shuchi. Nice seeing you guys again. The only fact that I would want to share over here is that we are talking about two aspects over here. Not only are we talking about the teacher empowerment, we also have to think from the student perspective. Of course, when you talk about teacher empowerment, we are looking at many educators just going ahead with any and every tech that anybody is using. So if we could actually just zero down on this, just like ma'am said, you know, on one of the platforms that we fix out, and we suggest that we go with this, which has the maximum participation. And why just fix it to only few people? Let's go YouTube live. Right now, I'm participating in one of the international webinars. It's live on YouTube, and around 8,000 people are already logged into that. Secondly, most important is the pedagogy. If it is not mapped to the tech, that is, if it is, the tech has to be mapped as per according to the learning outcomes. If that is not done, then I think we are in a lot of a situation which can cause a problem for the teachers and the students altogether.
Yes, ma'am. And let's not Armeet, ma'am, you are so in computer department, right?
Yeah, I'm heading the computer
so
department.
So probably you and Sarika Kaushal, ma'am, are you here?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, so we have two people who are good with technology and so on. So like this, we'll have to create a resource pool and probably, you know, then get into smaller groups and work on this. Because, you know, we all of us may not be equipped to give our ideas on that. So we'll create smaller groups and work towards this. And since time is running out, I'll just put in some news about the invitation that we are getting from the globals. You know, when we put up our programs on YouTube and Facebook, you know, we think that only Indians are seeing. A lot of people from abroad are also seeing. I was surprised because the moment we started putting our programs, the art integration series on Facebook and YouTube, we got a lot of calls inviting us for their forums from Europe, from US, from Australia and so on. In fact, one invitation that we've got is for next Saturday. I already shared that video with you. This is a group which is called the Educator Springboard Program. And this is called the Boston Pledge. So I'll be giving you this invitation. And they are meeting every Saturday, 7 to 8:30 p.m. And they are inviting all our core members as participants there. And I think teachers from three continents, Asia, Europe, and I think North America, these three continents teachers are going to meet. So I think let's also join hands with global leaders who are already into this so that we get an idea of what they are doing. So since we've got an invitation, I invite you all also to join. I'll send you the link and the registration. So we have the last 2 minutes. Anyone else wants to give a concluding?
So I'd like to say something.
Then I'll leave.
Somebody who didn't get a chance probably.
So may I, Ritika?
Ritika, yeah. Please.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Ritika Bhandari. I'm HOD Chemistry, Guru Har Krishan Public School. Sir, my suggestion one is please float a Google form in your FB and everywhere so that we can know the need of global people. I mean, what exactly are they looking for? One thing, that they should come up with their things, because I have seen that they are not
sharing resources as much we people are sharing there.
You are absolutely so right. 100% I agree with you. We are sharing everything. They keep it a secret. Yes.
No. The thing is, time constraints and time zone constraints are there. So they are not able to attend our webinars. So if we keep our webinars on the timings, then they can also be a part of it. That is one thing I have. And one more thing that I am, since from a science background and chemistry background, whosoever in this group is there, we can work as a team for coming up webinars in science and chemistry. That is one thing I just wanted to say.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. And Ritu, ma'am, you wanted to say something last?
Yeah, I'll wind up. Related to soft skills, sir, because at times now the interview panel has changed. We are going to have interviews now on like FaceTime or through Google Time. So in how to conduct those interviews, how principals should be conducting it, how I as a applicant should be giving the interview. So maybe things related to that can also be taken up somewhere.
Actually, we were planning a soft skill workshop with you. Unfortunately, due to the lockdown, that didn't happen.
Yeah, that all that.
So
that's anyway. Fine. We can manage that sometime.
Yeah.
That's no issue.
So I think that's it. So what we intend to do is that now let's work on this for the next 3 weeks, or this requires time. So we'll just get into smaller groups. We'll keep the discussion for just professional things. And, you know, I would request you not to forward unnecessary things, because enough and more is there in the other groups. So let's keep it only the subject, so that, you know, we don't lose track of what